The last thing I want to do now with probability is take a look at a couple of practice problems. Just take a look at a couple of scenarios and just calculate some probabilities based on the information that we're given. So here we go. We have probability of A has been given as 0.13, probability of B is 0.27, C is 0.18, and D is 0.62. Now, we know that A and D are mutually exclusive. So A and D are ME, mutually exclusive. And we're told that B and C are independent. Okay? Keep that in mind. Now, the very first thing we'll look at is what's the probability of A complement. Well, A complement is everything outside of A. So that probability will simply be everything, that's 1, minus the probability of A. That is the definition of A complement. Now, I could take everything outside of A and add them all up, but quite frankly, it's easier to take the whole thing, the whole universe, subtract from it A, and that's left with everything that is not in A, so that would give me my A complement. Well, this is going to be 1 minus, what's A? 0.13. There you go. Which is what, 0.87? So there's the solution. Probability of A complement is 0.87. Probability of A plus A complement, that's going to be 1, which we can quickly check. What's the probability of of B and C? Probability of B and C. Well, do we know anything special about B and C? B and C are independent. Boy, that helps. Because they're independent, we know this is the probability of B and C. Because they're independent, this just equals the probability of B times the probability of C. Now, I'm going to go back and rewrite this. Yeah, I'll leave that there for a second. Using the general multiplication rule, this would be equal to the probability of B given C times the probability of C. That's what the general multiplication rule says. But because we know they're independent, probability of B given C, because they're independent, is just the probability of B. And that brought me right back to what I first went to. Okay? So what is the probability of B times C? Well, B is 0.27. Let me see. This equals 0.27 times C is 0.18. You can grab a calculator or whatever and do the arithmetic, but there's your solution. Multiply those two guys together, and there you go. Let's see what's next. Probability of B given C. Well, I already kind of alluded to that. This is equal to the probability of B and C divided by the probability of C. However, because I know that the events B and C are given to us as being independent, this is the probability of B times the probability of C divided by the probability of C. The C's cancel out, and I'm left with the probability of B. I know that because they're independent. Right away, I could have said, hey, this is simply equal to the probability of B because we are told they are independent. And the probability of B is what? 0.27. There we go. Piece of cake. See, what's next? What's the probability of A and D? A and D. Well, based on the general multiplication rule, this would be the probability of A given D. Whoops. I wrote B. It said D. Sorry. Times the probability of D. By the way, for notation-wise, this is and. Okay, that's what that means. Well, let's see. A given D, they're mutually exclusive. So, if they're mutually exclusive, what's the probability of A given D happened? That's 0. Times, what's the probability of D? Times 0.62. That is simply 0. A and D can't happen. They're mutually exclusive. They don't overlap anywhere. The definition of mutually exclusive. And it looks like last but not least here, probability of A or D. This notation-wise could also be written as A or D. Okay, now we know that the probability of A or D will be equal to the probability of A plus the probability of D minus the probability of A and D. Remember the Venn diagram where they overlap, we have to subtract off because it gets counted twice. You need to get rid of one of them, so we only count it once. Well, probability of A is 0.13. Probability of D is 0.1. Oops. 0.62. Probability of A and D, what is that? Well, A and D are mutually exclusive, so A and D must be 0. So this is, what, 75? So the probability of A or D, because they're mutually exclusive, is just the sum of the individual probabilities, which is 0.75. And that's going to wrap it up for a couple of quick practice-type problems.